Hello, good evening friends. I am here to discuss with you some novel part of our system. It has been less explored part of our system. As on today, we have seen so many cases where homeopathy is said to have a lot of scope in chronic diseases, in cancer conditions, allergic conditions, autoimmune diseases. This is the first attempt I feel that where we are exploring a new field in clinical practice, homeopathic management of infertility. See, basically infertility is considered as one of the major cause of disturbance in many life of many couples. They are trying lot of treatments, definitely allopathic way. If the medication part doesn't help, then there are other techniques, what we call assisted techniques of reproduction, which involve IUI, IVF, GIFT, and so many other new. See, as the technology develops, there are so many techniques which are going on. But all are invasive techniques, and definitely over a period of time, even patients have experienced that there are a lot of side effects of these medications, especially the hormones which are given. Over a period of few years, we have observed in the practice that many couples are approaching us for the treatment of infertility. Like after the failure of conventional ways of treatment, or after facing the side effects of the treatment. And now in few years still, there is one more part. Patients are approaching to us as a first choice in the treatment of infertility. This is a very good development, because see, as one patient gets a good result, definitely they will refer another patient. They are confident that these medicines have no side effects. They are helping us in a smooth way without disturbing their day-to-day life. Post-treatment also there are no side effects. These are all positive things which we have observed over a period of so many years of treating cases of infertility. Now basically, when we treat infertility, there is nothing great that we are doing. We are just following the principles of homeopathy. But there are so many different problems which are diagnosed nowadays because of the development of technologies. New tests are available. We can find out the cause of the disease, why there is a problem of infertility in a particular couple, male infertility, female infertility, or there are so many advanced hormonal tests which are available, which helps us to exactly point towards the clinical problem, towards the cause of infertility in that particular couple. And the process of case taking, what we do in homeopathy, we have to follow a different insight for these kind of cases to study. It is not that like conventionally what we treat like cough, cold, fever. See, each and every couple which is eager to conceive, definitely they come to us with that strong feeling of having a baby. But paradoxically, they are not able to conceive in spite of having that strong feeling. So there is a contradictory situation. They want to conceive, but they are not able to conceive. So what is there in the system of the patient, which is making the pregnancy difficult? See, being pregnant or reproduce the same species is a nature's law. Nature has provided all living beings with the quality of reproduction. Everybody, even smallest of small creatures also, they are reproducing. But there is a difference in when we start treating humans and we compare the reproductive functions of other animals. Humans have a main part in our system, what our homeopathy has recognized it as a mind. Definitely, we homeo as a homeopath, we focus on mind-body correlation. What is the cause of infertility? PCOD, other hormonal imbalance, hypothyroidism, obesity. These are all clinical terms and proven clinical conditions which are the probably main cause of infertility. But we are not going to treat as a homeopath only hypothyroidism, only obesity, only PCOD. We as a homeopath, we treat the patient as a whole. As we are taught, we know, we treat the patient at a level of mind, soul and spirit. The problem is identified at this level and we treat the case with pure homeopathic medicines which are proved. See, one more thing now. If you see a patient who has been treated with lot of hormones, like traditionally what they treat for inducing ovulation, for controlling a thyroid problem, for controlling obesities, like you may be aware, so many medicines are given. Even for young girls, they give anti-diabetic medicine to control the weight also. Does our homeopathic medicine have such a strong and such a deep acting effect to control all these problems? Where we can find this? See, when we are indulging in such a great treatment, see, this treating infertility just gives, and when you get good results, it gives immense pleasure and immense satisfaction of our career, that we homeopathy can create a great difference in somebody's life who are in a state of sorrow, a state of depression because they are not able to conceive for years together. So before we indulge in this system, indulge in this kind of treatment, it is very important that we should be well versed with our principles. See, definitely we are not going to disobey or find some new ways of treating infertility apart from the principles laid down by our masters. But we have to develop an insight as how we can utilize what we call applied homeopathy. See, I always call this treating particular specialty conditions. See, as a homeopath, we never see that there are different specialists in homeopathy. Rheumatologist, cardiologist, diabetologist, or what you say, infertility specialist. We are not treating patient in fragments. So now when we approach this patient with a concept that, okay, we are treating infertility and we are going to learn on 15th and 16th of this July coming week about approach towards the cases of infertility in homeopathy. What we are going to learn is how we can apply this knowledge of homeopathy in general and specifically in treating the cases of infertility. What we have to see, what we have to perceive, and what are the special conditions or special, what we can say, as I have always called, psychoneuroendocrine axis disturbances, which takes place in the condition of when we want to treat cases of infertility with homeopathy. So these are very, see, before we go into such a depth of understanding of homeopathic approach towards infertility, we have to be very clear in our concepts, basic concepts of homeopathy. What we are going to treat in a patient? Are we going to treat ovarian cyst? And see, second part, when we start treating the cases, definitely suppose the patient conceives, what is our approach towards the case? See, only conceiving is not a problem. Once your remedy is right, patient will definitely conceive. We have to help the patient to continue the pregnancy uneventful till the delivery of the baby. How homeopathic medicine can help to continue the pregnancy? See, we are whatever patients we treat with at our clinic, we always try to see to it that we follow with them till the delivery. See, delivery part we cannot do in our clinic. You need a proper setup, gynecological setup. But at least full medical management with tackling. See, there could be another conditions developing during pregnancy, as we learn in our college days. Diabetes during pregnancy, hypothyroidism during pregnancy, hyperthyroidism during pregnancy, not gaining weight during pregnancy, or hyperemesis. There are so many different conditions which a patient can develop because these are not normal lifetime situations. This is a different condition. So when we start following up this patient, definitely we should have that much confidence to tackle all these different kind of medical conditions during pregnancy, and absolutely with homeopathy. See, this over a period of time, I have seen that this, if you see professionally, this field has a vast, homeopathy has a vast scope in this field. Patients are really searching or yearning for some good approach to treat their conditions. As always, we say rapid, gentle and permanent way. That gentleness, what our medicines have, allopathic, see, I'm not criticizing allopathic system of medicine, but if we compare the way we treat and way patients are treated there, if patients find a lot of difference in homeopathic approach, they are very happy. It may not be that every time we get 100% success. We cannot assure that yes, 100% I can treat you. There are conditions which seems to be very easily treatable, but we fail. There are conditions which seems to be untreatable and we got fantastic results. So such conditions are always there. So what is important? Our approach to such cases. To understand the philosophy of homeopathy, principle of homeopathy, and I always insist that whatever the condition we are treating, whatever cause of infertility we are trying to treat in the patient, we have to follow the basic laws of homeopathy, basic principles of homeopathy. We cannot compromise on the principles of homeopathy for treating any condition. I always feel ki even if you have treated the patient without considering the principles of homeopathy, otherwise giving, like, you know, there is a concept of organ remedies. If the patient is not getting proper ovulation, in some books it is mentioned that we give folliculinum, euphorinum. Definitely you can use these remedies, but if there is a proper indication, what we use is a similimum, the indicated remedy. So we cannot deviate from the basic principles of homeopathy. What will happen over a period of time, we will lose the art in homeopathy. See, as on today, we always feel that it is not a mechanical system. It is not a mechanical system of treatment. It is an artistic treatment. Always, no, we know homeopathy is art and science. So definitely I am going to share the scientific part of homeopathy. What our homeopathic remedies are, the hormones, how they are going to affect the hormones, and before that, how we are going to search where the disturbance lies. And in our hand, we have a strong scientific evidence of action of homeopathic medicine in the form of drug proving by our masters. So what are the hormones given by allopathic way of, in the allopathic way of treatment, and what are the remedies given, similimum given in the homeopathic way of treatment? We have to compare the effects and side effects. There are cases where patient is being drugged with lot and lot of hormones. We have cases where patient has undergone 3 times IVF, 5 times IUI. As you know, Dr. Hahnemann has said, these patients who are over-drugged, they become incurable just by virtue of over-drugging. So in such cases, how we are going to approach? Because see, once we take the case, like, as we have to remove the basic cause of the disease and the other obstacles to cure. So whatever obstacles to cure we come across during treatment of such cases, that we have to consider. These things I'm going to discuss with you in the coming webinar. So I hope all of you would join the webinar, understand my concept. I have some failure cases also, where I was confident of getting the result but no results. And there are different reverse cases also. It was considered as a hopeless case, and the homeopathy had made wonder in this. So let us meet, let us discuss and share our experiences, and definitely grow our homeopathic system in the field of treatment of infertility. Okay, so hope to see you on 15th July, 7 p.m. Thank you.